Hold on a second. Well, my friend just hit his nail on his head. Well, now you can ponder or wonder, what am I talking about here? Well, I'm talking about the phrase and idioms today, okay? Well, now there's a lot of phrase and idioms out there that can help you out to improve your English dramatically, okay? Now let's learn 5 best phrases and idioms that you can use in your daily conversation. Now first, that I've just said, which is hit the nail on the head. Now what does it really mean? Does it really mean hit your nail on your head? Not really. It means get something, you know, exactly. Let's say you were just looking for a solution for some problems and you got an idea, or maybe you found a solution. You can say, hey, I just hit my nail on the head. That means you get exactly what you're looking for. Now let's go ahead and talk about the second one, which is called big fish to fry. Now, how can you use big fish to fry? Now, imagine you're having a conversation and you have something important to do. And your friend is telling you, hey, let's go for a walk. And you say, come on, man, you know what? I got a big fish to fry. That means you have something important to do, okay? Now let's talk about the other expression or a phrase and idioms called break the ice. Now, what does that really mean? Break the ice basically means to make people, you know, let's say more comfortable about something. Now, let's say you don't talk to people a lot and, you know, one of your friends came up and said, hey, why don't you just break the ice? That means let's say he's just trying to tell you, just go ahead and talk to everybody so that everybody can feel a little bit comfortable. So you can use that in that situation, like, hey, let's break an ice, okay? Now let's go ahead and talk about the next one is called cost and arms and legs. Now imagine you wanna buy a car, that's definitely expensive, let's say very expensive. Now you can simply say, well, that car is gonna, you know, cost my arms and legs. That simply means that car is very expensive. Now let's talk about the last expression called don't give up your day job. Now your boss definitely can tell you that. Now let's say you are working on a project and you're about to give up and your boss can come up and can say, hey, don't give up your day job, okay? Well, that can certainly mean that you are not really good at this. At this point, you have to do a little bit of hard work on that project, okay? You also can use the same thing. Well, let's say don't give up your day job in order to inspire your friends. So that's all about this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. If you so, just let me know in the comment section. So that's all about this video. Thanks and stay chill. Have a good time.